Lyme disease affects the patient in many different ways. It depends on which stage of the disease we're looking at. In the first stage, the early stage that occurs about 7 to 10 days after a tick bite, Lyme disease affects the skin where the tick bit the person. The skin is infected with the bacteria and it causes a round or oval red skin lesion called erythema migrans. And that may or may not be associated with kind of flu-like symptoms like feeling flu-like, achy, chills, sweats, fatigue, malaise. And that combination of the skin lesion and those flu-like symptoms are the primary manifestations of the first stage of Lyme disease. If you don't treat the first stage of Lyme disease, then in many patients, probably more than half, the bacteria leaves the skin where it was initially inoculated and goes through the bloodstream to other areas of the body. And then the manifestations change because now other areas of the body are infected, primarily the nervous system, the joints, and the heart. And so those manifestations are different. If it affects the nervous system, it may cause what's called a Bell's palsy or a drooping face. It can cause meningitis with headache and stiff neck. And it can cause heart problems if the bacteria goes to the heart. Those heart problems are usually a slow heart rate that may cause the person to pass out or feel like they're going to pass out. The symptoms of second stage Lyme disease are probably often the most difficult to ascertain. They are symptoms such as fatigue, generalized achiness of the muscles and joints, and sometimes patients also note to what they call brain fog type cognitive symptoms where they have trouble with short-term memory and trouble multitasking. These symptoms, though, again, are not specific for Lyme disease and sometimes can make the diagnosis of second stage Lyme disease very difficult. Now, if we have objective signs such as facial palsy or heart abnormalities or meningitis, then we can more easily make the diagnosis of second stage Lyme disease. But in the absence of those outward manifestations of disease, relying on the symptoms alone is often problematic. Physicians may not think of second stage Lyme disease in somebody who has a fatigue or generalized achiness, and so we really have to think about it and then order the appropriate testing to make that diagnosis. Third stage doesn't occur for months or even years later, and that stage is called late Lyme arthritis. That's where a joint, usually a knee joint, swells up and has fluid accumulation and pain. And that's actually the way the disease was discovered in Lyme, Connecticut. It was an outbreak of joint arthritis in young children. So the symptoms vary a lot depending on what stage we're talking about.